go to talk to that spouse. Prayer is the best way to talk to that boss. So what? Prayer. So your time. Time. Time is important. Time is important. Time is important. You are where you are today because of what you did yesterday. You are where you are today because of the decision you made well yesterday. You will be where you are in the future based on the decision you make what? Today. Sow your time. Sow your time. And God will help us to not waste time in Jesus' name. Please don't spend all your time watching television, Telemundo. Which one again? Soccer. I love those things. But don't waste all your time. They are not paying you. You know, when I was growing up, when I was in high school, we used to fight over football players. This player is better than that player. Those players are making billions. Why would I fight for you? Everybody know what I'm saying? Please don't waste time. Time is too precious. Time is very important. See, the greatest men in the world, believers or not believers, time is of importance to them. How many of you know that? That's why you don't see them often. The greatest men and women, time is of what? Importance. Please save your time. Sleep early, wake up early. Don't sleep late and wake up late. God is watching you with the time. He's saying, the time I've given you, have you sown it well? Have you sown that 24 hours I've given you? Have you sown it well? There are many people that are weak, they are alive today. If you are alive, what do you do? Sow your time. Sow your time. Spend your time with God. You know, sometimes you don't even have to pray. Sometimes when I just meditate. Can you meditate for once? What do you do? Meditate. You can drive and just think about God. How do you want to solve this issue? Sometimes you can sit down and envision where you want to be. You know, whatever you see, that one comes to you. Bible says to Abraham in Genesis 15, he says, see, I've given you all this. I've given you. What did he tell Abraham to do first to? See. We'll look at that later. See. Your eyes is not only for seeing people, it's for looking ahead. Your eyes will see far ahead where you are right now. Because what you see is what you get. And from now on, we march forward in Jesus' name. How many of you are still with me? If you are with me, shout hallelujah. As I said, don't sleep. This is not the time to sleep. This is the time to stay awake. Because God is dropping some bombs. That when they explode, when you come and give your testimony, you don't have to say anything because it shows already. Amen. Amen. The word of God. So the word of God. Psalm 119, verse 105. Say, thy word have I in my heart that I might not sin against you. So the word of God. Brethren, the word of God is powerful. And sharper than any two-edged sword. I've seen it work many times in my life. Many times. Last Sunday, man, I had the flu. Nobody knew. Because when you are going through something, not anybody has to know. I had flu, as in, I don't have flu in Jesus' name. But it was, I saw the symptoms, everything. I was acting, I was very just wobbly. I just sat down, you know. But I said, God, you almost says in Exodus 23:25, you say you bless my bread and water. What will happen? You take sickness and disease from me. Let's open to it. Exodus 23:25. Exodus 23:25. I want to put your eyes on the word. Open your Bible. Exodus 23:25. He says, so you shall serve the Lord your God. And he shall what? Bless your bread and your water. And I will remove sickness from your midst. And he said, no one shall be miscarried or barren in your land. I will feed the number of your days. I heard the pastor say, he said, if a goat can give birth, I cannot be barren. Hallelujah. Eh? Anybody listening? If somebody, if an animal that doesn't pray can give birth, I cannot what? That comes from meditation on the word of God. It becomes life. It's like, forgive me, you know I'm very excited. What manifests on the outside is what has become life inside. Amen. I am rich because I am rich inside. Amen. You are rich because you are what? Rich inside. You are healthy because you are healthy what? Inside. You are prosperous because you are prosperous what? Inside. The word must become flesh. It must become life. Please sow the word of God. The word of God must become life. One time I was taking a walk and I heard one demon say, what is snake come? I said, that snake will die. Forgive me because, sorry, I'm very radical. I was walking, you know, sometimes we take walk, you know, exercise. And one user said, what is snake bite you? I said, the snake will die. Like Paul, you know, when the snake beat Paul, what did Paul do? He shook into the fire. You're not serious, are you? It comes from meditation on the what? On the word of God. That word will become flesh. So who read Bible like story? You know, so when I talk to my brother, I say, what do you read? He said, I read 1 Samuel. I read 1 Kings. You know, that's all, where the stories are. And David went to Bathsheba. They'll read that one. And David sinned. They'll read that one. It's good. You know what you read? I read 1 Chronicles, Solomon. Bible is not story. It's from the word. It's still good. He read the Bible. When I asked him, he said, that's what I read. I read Genesis, and God created heaven and the earth. Good job. But God wants you to meditate what? On the scripture. May God help us in Jesus' name. So the word of God. And so goodwill towards others. So goodwill towards others. It's a series of own. So goodwill towards others. Matthew 5:7. Matthew 5:7. Matthew 5:7. So goodwill. And it's Matthew 5:7, no Malachi. Matthew 5:7. Blessed are the merciful, what happened? They shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain. There are many times I've been struggling in life, and God sent you to help me. God will send help to you in Jesus' name. You know, one time I was studying the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 12, and I saw that David was a helped man. See, any man that is blessed or woman that is blessed is helped. God sent men. I even wrote, I did a study on it. God sent to him men of valor. God sent to him men of undivided heart. God sent unto him brave warriors. That's 1 Chronicles 12. For those who have got 1 Chronicles 12. He sent men of Manasseh. He sent men of sincere heart. God sent men to David. David was a powerful man because of the men he had. You know, when you look at that scripture, David said, one of the generals slew 5,000 people. If you read that scripture, one slew 10 people with a jaw of a rat's bone. He had men. He had great men. But David was a nice man. Can you imagine a man that is a warrior but can also write hymns and songs? A man that is a warrior can also cry before the presence of God. So goodwill. These are the men that helped him throughout as a king. No man stands on his own. How many of you know that? No man can what? I've learned that one. Just have the best people around you. No man can stand on his own. We are all health people. No man can stand what? On his own. You cannot stand on your own. You need help. And God will send help to you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God will send help to you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I'll give an example. Then Gio came to Alabama. So it was a tough thing to do because I drove 2 hours from work. Now I drive another 3 hours to where? Birmingham. It was very tough. But God said I should do some things. But by God's grace, I saw that the Jew. I saw him. I'll stop there because that's where we stop. But God used somebody to connect me. And I saw him. And you know, we conversed for a few minutes. God will send help to you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every great man is a helped man. Every great man is what? God will send help to you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
See, let me tell you something. You can't be great without helped people coming to you. You can't be great without great men being under you. I'm talking men, women included.